All right. Welcome to this episode of Grade School with Saint. Today, we are going to kick things off with Flesh and Blood, talking about Welcome to Wraith. Of course, as you see on this case, it's a little beat up case. This is a Welcome to Wraith unlimited booster case. Everything is sealed. This case is currently, the boxes inside are currently running 130 to 150, making cases, I think, between $500 and $600 a case. However, as of the filming of this video, there are shipments coming from overseas, from New Zealand to the U.S., and there is a restock. So by the time you're watching this, I believe the product will be much more prevalent, will be on store shelves because it is mid-February, and they promised they'd get it to us in the month of February. So we've opened up, and we are going to do one box of Welcome to Wraith Unlimited. You can tell that it's unlimited because there's this little strip that says unlimited. The Alpha Edition, the original, the very first print, the prototype product, has Alpha written over here. So this is obviously plastered with unlimited, and it's everywhere over the pack. We're starting with this product because this is basically Unlimited Edition was made for players. There's a little bit of a collectability element, and you still get the same fun of the whole loot farming, equipment farming element as well. And it's a much lower entry point because as of the filming, these boxes being 130 to 150, they're, older brother versions, the original alphas, are 4,000 and up. So this is a great place for people learning about and wanting to collect and build their first decks in Flesh and Blood. It's good for them to start with Welcome to Wraith Unlimited. Welcome to Wraith introduces the first four characters, first four heroes of the game. I pulled the first one, that's Katsu. Let's see a couple more. We've got Katsu, we've got Reinar, we've got my favorite, Dorinthia, the warrior, and what else do we have? Oh, the last one, the Guardian. So, you get your first four heroes, Reinar, the Brute, Katsu, the Ninja, Dorinthia, the Warrior, and Bravo, the Guardian. So, all four pack arts are there. Like I said, you can see unlimited on the packs. And just in case we pull something interesting, I've got our sleeves for the foils, the majestic rares, the super rares. And in case we pull something really spicy, like a legendary card or a fabled card, I've got the Ultra Pro semi-rigid card holders. I always go with Ultra Pro just out of habit and because, in my opinion, after seeing all the card holders on the market, these Ultra Pro card holders are the best. Please note that they are a little more pricey than the rest, but they are definitely the highest quality out there. So without any further ado, let's get started. Let's look into a pack of Welcome to Wraith. All right, first off, wow, I think we're in for a treat. If I'm not mistaken, this card is the token card and it is actually a cracked bauble. Bang, there we go, cracked bauble. Normally, there's one card, which is a token card. Now, the cracked bauble is a resource. It's used for limited format when you're playing draft, when you're playing sealed, and you need just an extra filler card to pitch for two resources. So that's a cracked bauble. We're going to put that to the side with the rest of the commons and tokens. We're going to flip it over, look at the card. See, there are a couple of generic cards in the beginning. These are all commons. You can tell the rarity by the bottom left. There's a little circle. So that's a pink sink below. We've got a yellow pitch pummel. We've got a blue pitch barraging brown hide and a yellow pitch raging onslaught. Then we've got one piece of equipment, common equipment. You see common down here. And then this is where you get to the interesting part. The first rare, and it's always a rare, is here it's a barraging brown hide. You can see there's an R symbol, rarity, rare. The next card can be anything from rare to super rare to majestic. And that is an M. Let's see. R, S, or M. Ooh, and we're in for a hit. This is a remembrance. This is kind of like a regrowth from Magic the Gathering. It costs zero. That's its casting cost, zero. It pitches for two resources, or generates basically two mana. And here, it shuffles up to three action cards from your graveyard into your deck. It's a generic instant, and when you have super rares like this one, this is an S. Majestics have an M on them. Especially generics, they're more valuable than their class-specific counterparts. So you could tell it's generic because it says generic. For example, this rare over here, this is just a brute rare. This is a class-specific rare because it's an action for the brute, hence a brute action. And a super rare is significantly more valuable, more scarce, and it's generic, so anybody can play it. So hence, that's why the generic cards are a little more collectible than the rest. And the third hit, in this case, just a foil common, rainbow foil, is just a common Buckling Blow. So put the foils over there. Let's look at the rest of the packs. We've got a red. See, now we've got seven additional class-specific cards. This is a Primeval Bellow for the Brute, another Buckling Blow for the Guardian, Wreck-A-Romp for the Brute, Stonewall Confidence for the Guardian, Iron Song Response for the Warrior, Leg Tap for the Ninja, and last, we've got another Iron Song Response, the Red Pitch. So here, in this game, there are different pitches, meaning that you can discard or put into the pitch pile, or like the word says, pitch, you can throw away for different amounts of mana. They may be the same card, but they do different things. I don't have a third Iron Song Response, but I'll just show you guys. Blue pitch usually pitches, are always pitches for three. Yellow pitch pitches for two. And red pitch pitches for one. But usually the blue pitch has the least amount of impact in the card because it provides the most resources. But in this case, let's compare yellow and red. The yellow pitch, Iron Song Response, is zero casting cost, or costs zero resources to use. The red one also costs zero, so the casting cost is the same. The defense value on the bottom right are the same, but the cards themselves, there gotta be trade-offs for the different pitch values. So this pitches for more. This card basically discards for more resources, but it's less effective. So its effect reprise, if the defending hero has defended with a card from their hand this chain link, target weapon attack gains plus two attack. So this augments an attack by plus two, and it pitches for two. The red, and red pitch usually is the most impactful, only pitches for one. But here it says the defending hero, if defending hero has defended with a card from their hand this chain link, target weapon gains plus three. So you've got one additional attack, one less pitch. So really quick, just going through the different pitch values. All right, because there are 24 packs in a box. Let's speed this up now that we've gone through the layout of a pack. As said earlier, see, Harmonize Kodachi, Dorinthia. You've got a young hero token plus a weapon token. So that is the token. Got the generic commons, Nimble Strike, Nimbleism, Wounded Blow, Nimble Strike again, and the gear, Snapdragon Scalers. And now for the good stuff. Got the Staunch Response. Ooh, we've got a Drone of Brutality, a very popular generic action, rare attack. And we've got the Primeval Bellow, the foil. All right. Let's keep on digging for some good stuff. Let's see what else there is. Okay, Harmonize Kodachi, Katsu, that's the token. Let's get to the cards. We've got Nimbleism, Onslaught, Scar for Scar, Flock, Helm of Aizen's Peak. All right, for the rares, there's the Disable, rather strong card, 5 casting cost, 8 damage. We have a Barraging Beatdown, blue pitch, got one of those before. Ooh, this one's interesting. We have a rainbow foil, blackout kick. The foiling isn't as radiant as on the WTR Alpha, but it's still a nice card. Little aggressive, violent art. Guy getting decapitated. All right, moving along. Got a Quicken token, Dawnblade. That's Dorinthia's weapon. Every single weapon has different characteristics to it in this game. Onslaught, Unmovable, Wounded Blow, and Demolition Crew. Iron Rot Legs is the gear. And for the rares, we've got a Fluster Fist. Ooh, this is interesting. A Bonehead Barrier. This is a super rare. You see down there, Bonehead Barrier. Costs one. Roll a six-sided die, prevent the next X damage that would be dealt to your hero this turn, where X is the number rolled. Okay, and not so much of a notable card, just a leg tap. One for four damage, ninja attack. All right, next pack, let's take a look. Usually, there's one rainbow foil equipment per box, so hopefully we'll get that. One in four boxes is going to contain a legendary rainbow equipment, so hopefully we'll get that. Let's take a look. We've got the plate, brood attack, breakneck battery. Ooh, this is nice. Ancestral empowerment. We've hit our first majestic, and this is a very, oh, wow. Okay, you know what? Wow. All right, let me get through this majestic really quick. Ancestral empowerment, target ninja attack action card gains plus one attack, and draw a card for zero. So this is a very special card for the ninja, but this is definitely outdone by, we're just talking about it. This is amazing. This is a legendary. As you can see, an L on our first episode. This is basically the equivalent of a Power 9 card in Welcome to Wraith. This is the Guardian chest piece. So this is basically a legendary gear for the Guardian. And as you can see, once per turn, create a resource, or spend a resource, create a Seismic Surge token, and go again. So that means you spend a resource and you can later on have one mana in storage and you can use this once per turn. This is a beautiful card. It's a nice rainbow foil. You can see the foiling right there. And yeah, it blocks for two. And then after it's battle worn, it can block for one more, meaning after it blocks for two and you put a minus one counter on it, it can block for one additional damage. So this is probably the best chess piece for the Guardian class. And this is definitely a hit, a very, very strong hit. Wow. So early in the case, and we've already hit that piece. That's pretty amazing. Then again, I've heard that the unlimited printing has has been a little more generous to players and collectors than the alpha printing. We've got Bravo. That's the Guardian that uses the tectonic chess piece. All right, let's see. We've got Red Sync below, Nimble Strike, Braunhide, and Demo Crew. Refraction Bolters is the gear. The Warrior's Valor, okay, Drone of Brutality, and for a foil, just a Scar for a Scar, Yellow Pitch. Put that in a sleeve, and we move right along. Okay, the Reinar token with Bravo on the other side. Got the Onslaught, Scour the Battlescape, Pummel, and Featherwalkers. With the gear, common equipment, Iron Rot Plate. Okay, we've got the card Flick Flack, very popular card. Defends for four, whereas most cards defend for two or three. This one defends for four, and if the next card you defend with has combo, it gains plus two. So ninjas are usually weaker on defense, but a card like this helps a ninja defend for up to six, because four plus two, and it costs zero. So amazing, amazing card. Very often played. We've got the Blackout Kick, Not in foil, same interesting art with the decapitation, 16 and up game. And for the foil, we've got a rare foil. Yep, rare rainbow foil. We've got a rare disable, blue pitch. Good card, okay. Moving on, next pack. The seismic surge token, see? What I said about resources from the tectonic plating. Tectonic plating basically creates a token. Seismic surge token at beginning of your action phase, destroy the token. Then the next guardian action card you play costs one less resource. So you're basically storing up mana for the next turn with tectonic plating. And the Kodachi. All right. Generics, unmovable, scar for a scar, slog, scour the battlescape, hope merchant's hood. And we go to the rares. Savage Feast. Ooh, a red snatch. In another show, we say that the red snatch is literally the best snatch because it attacks for the most, draws a card, and yeah, it's 4 damage, whereas the blue snatch only has 2 damage, and the yellow snatch has 3 damage, and it's become a little bit of a meme, some inside jokes in the community. As for the foil, we've got a pack hunt. All right, next pack. Reinar welcomes us. Let's see if there's anything else. Oh, there's Young Dorinthea, favorite of the 4 heroes. Okay, blow, reflex, slogism, crew. And Dorinthea's bolters, warrior equipment. We've got a breakneck battery, warrior's valor. Ooh, this is a pretty one. Pretty art, sharpened steel. Yellow pitch, sharpened steel. Little weaker than the red pitch. All right, there's a Katsu token. See what's on the other side. Romping Club, Brute Weapon. Okay, Onslaught, Movable, Scour, Reflex. That's the cross trap. We've got a Disable for the Guardian, Steel Blade Shunt for the Warrior, and another red Blackout Kick foil. All right, see that rainbow foiling? There we go. All right, almost halfway there. Let's see. Got the Kodachi, Reinar, Young Reinar, 4 generics, strapping, Steel Blade Shunt. Ooh, that defends for 6, but it costs 1. And even when it defends, you can do damage to the attacking hero. All right, Blackout Kick, cool. And we've got the Razor Reflex, the foil blue Razor Reflex. All right, halfway mark. We're already doing very well. This is not the norm, of course, because you normally don't see a legendary equipment in every box. So we are doing quite good. We're kicking things off in style. Okay. Generics, couple pummels, okay, Goliath Gauntlet. Ah, a red snatch followed by another red snatch. So we're at 2 red snatches for the box. Sand Sketch Plan, that is a super rare. As you can see, it's a blue super rare, so pitches for 3, costs 0. Reinar Specialization, special card for Reinar. Only, you can only play this card if you have Reinar. Search your deck for a card, put it in your hand. Discard a random card, then shuffle your deck. If the discarded card has 6 or more attack, gain 2 action points. So action points means you can take multiple actions. Kind of basically it gives you a little bit of a time walk mechanic because you get to act 2 additional times from the sand sketched plan. Pretty nice card, but there's the element of randomness. Random discards. All right, working on the right part of the box. Reinar again, Harmonized Kadachi Ninja Weapon. We've got Bull, Scar, Slog, Onslaught. Okay, here's the plate. All right, we've got the Guardian Defense, Staunch Response, Warrior Action, Warrior's Valor. Ooh, this is a nice card, especially in foil. Very often used, it's an instant. Basically, it gains 3 life. Think of this as a healing salve in the game of Magic. You can use instants anytime, that's why they're instants. And it costs 0, so it's 3 life. In this game where the Blitz format is, players start at 20 life, as you can see for Katsu, 20 life, 3 life, that's an instant 15% gain right there. So it's rather substantial. It sees a lot of play. All right, we've got the Kadachi and Dorinthia, also 20 life. Nimblism times 2, crew and movable, and the bolters. Okay, Steel Blade Shunt, Throne of Brutality, and an Emerging Power. That's interesting art. A lot of red. Emerging Power, an aura. Okay. Ah, there's Bravo. Got Adult Bravo, 40 life in the classic format. Classic format, you play with 60 cards. Blitz format, the 20 life format, you play with 40 cards. So slightly different rules. Strike, pummel, strike, blow, Hope Merchant's Hood. We've got a Savage Feast, Barraging Beatdown, both for the Brute. And for the foil, we've got a Driving Blade. Viewers, I know I said that these are not nearly as valuable as their alpha counterparts, but I still sleeve foils just because they're pretty beautiful, nice foils. Foils also damage a lot more easily, and I'm also just a creature of habit. Here's Young Dorinthia, 20 life, and Young Reinar, double-sided token. All right, Braunheit, Slogism, Featherwalker, Sink, and Ironrot Helm. We've got a red overpower. Ooh, this is interesting. Mugenchi Release. This is a Katsu, our ninja specialization. Combo of Whelming Gust Wave was the last attack in this combat chain. Mugenchi Release gains +1 attack. Go again, and if this hits, search your deck for any number of cards named Lord of Wind, reveal them, put them in your hand, and shuffle your deck. That is strong. 1 for 4, maybe 5, and go again, and you get additional cards. So this definitely combos well. That is a super rare, seen by the purple S on the bottom. All right, and the foil is Scour the Battlescape. Okay, third of the box left. Let's see if we can get any more hits. Obviously, I think we already got the best one possible, given the box. And, well, we'll see. Quicken Token, Romping Club. All right, Scour, Blow, Reflex, Slog is a Man, Breaking Scales. Yellow Sigil, 2 life instead of 3. Time Snap Potion. Now, this is an interesting one. Gain 2 action points. So, kind of that whole Time Walk mechanic. You drop it in the beginning, and you burn 1 action point so that you have it on the board. You place it on the board, and later on, you can have additional action points. All right, so that's the potion. Ooh, this is what I was talking about earlier. The Common Equipment Rainbow Foil. Pretty foiling. Nice card, worth a couple bucks. Just generic equipment. This is the one you expect. You don't expect a Tectonic Plating every box. I think this card is probably in the 100 to 180 range. Somewhere in that range, a 3-figure card. So definitely doing well for this box. But normally, we expect one generic piece of equipment on average. All right, we've got our token. Seen a couple of those by now. Oops. All right, we've got the commons, gauntlet, energy potion. See, this potion, same type of thing, pitches for 3, 0 casting cost. You could place it on the board, and when you destroy it, you get two additional resources. So 0 for 2, that's a great deal, and it's an instant as well. So it's stronger than an action. You can instantly basically summon resources. Flick Flack and Blue, 0 for 4, 2+2, and it pitches for 3. Interesting card. And for the foil, we've got a Stroke of Foresight. Look at that art. That's really, really beautiful art. Interesting card. Nice foiling. Nice little accents over there. Get that in a sleeve, and we move on. Oh, this is how we started. And there's one close to the close. Cracked Bauble, always a familiar friend. Cracked Baubles are said to bring us luck. We've got the commons, Refraction Bolters. There's the Blue Snatch. As stated, the Blue Snatch attacks for 2, pitches for 3, but attacks for 2. So it's the weakest snatch as well as the worst snatch. Ooh, this is a nice one. A Majestic Crippling Crush. Wow, okay. We've got Majestic on Majestic action, but let's go through the Crippling Crush review. This is likely currently, in this current game state, the strongest card for the Guardian. It's a Majestic. It costs 7 resources to cast. It's Bravo specialization, so you have to have Bravo. It's got a mechanic called Crush. If Crippling Crush deals 4 or more damage to a hero, they discard 2 random cards. And it hits for 11, so this is really a powerhouse. It is a monster of a card. Normally, cards defend for 3. This is 11. That means it's probably going to make them have to discard their hand unless they have something really strong. And then if it hits for 4 or more, it still makes them discard 2 random cards. Before we get to the really nice card following, I just wanted to say, look, normally, this is one's intellect. Normally, you start with 4 cards because you draw up to your intellect. So after it hits and they need to pitch or burn cards to defend, they discard half of their hand if it hits for 4 or more. So again, I can't say enough how strong this is. And again, we've got amazing Majestic on foil Majestic action here. Look at that. That is Tirinthia, the Warrior Super. This is a box and a half because you have the Steel Blade Supremacy Rainbow Foil Majestic. See by the M. It's 1 casting cost. It's Tirinthia's specialization. I call it their super move. Until end of turn, target weapon gains +2 attack, and whenever this weapon hits, draw a card. So it gives itself go again, meaning you can do other things. It only costs 1, but for the rest of the turn, your warrior, your Tirinthia, is buffed for 2 more attack, and then every single time it strikes, you get to draw a card. That is a beast of a card. So, all right. Glad to hit some interesting finds before the end of the box. Let's see if there's anything else. Again, we're doing really well for the box. I'd be surprised if there was anything more than 1 more super rare, but let's see. That's the fun of opening product. Got the commons. All right. Gauntlet. Blessing of Deliverance. Savage Feast. Couple of rares. Okay. Open the center. Really, really cool art. Just a common, though. If head jab, you know, open the center, gains +1. Go again, dominate. Interesting combo card. Couple packs left. The token. Generics. Scalers. Okay, I think we saw all the potions. This is the 3rd potion. Potion of Strength. Destroy Potion of Strength. Next attack gets +2. Takes an action, but it replaces itself because you've got to go again. 2 extra damage, 2 free damage. Rare card. We've got an Overpower, and, okay, the foil is just a Demolition Crew, generic attack. Nothing much to write home about. 2 for 6. Generic attack. All right, last 3 packs. We've got Bravo. Bravo and Katsu. The young guys. Okay. 4 generics. Helm of Aizen's Peak. Drone of Brutality. Blessing of Deliverance. And Raging Onslaught. Pretty cool art. 3 casting costs for 7 damage. Not the best. Nothing else to say. Some flavor text. And yeah. Cool art. Not the most useful card. 2 packs left. There's Big Boy Reinar. And the Kadachi. Got Scour, Slogism, Immovable, x2. We've got the Helm. Ooh, another energy potion. Potions are nice and useful. Steel Blade Shunt, Blue Pitch. And we've got a Cartilage Crush. Oof, we took a hit to the Solar Plexus. We were expecting a good card, but just a Cartilage Crush. All right, last pack magic. Let's see, guys. Let's see. Quicken Token, Dawn Blade, Dorinthia's Weapon. Okay, the generics are Flock, Reflex, Blow, Strike, Hope Merchant's Hood, generic equipment. Okay, Sigil of Solace, good card, instant for 3 life. We spoke about that earlier. Staunch Response, Guardian Defense. Not the best. Come on. Oh, and a Nimbleism common foil in the close. All right. Not bad at all. Not bad. Let's review the hits, starting from the super rares. In order, we have Sand Sketch Plan, a Brute super rare, Bonehead Barrier, Brute defensive card, Mugenshu Release, Ninja Specialization, and last, Remembrance. My opinion, the best super rare. Okay, for the Majestics, we've got Bravo's Crippling Crush. We've got the Ninja Ancestral Empowerment for damage and draw card. Majestic Rainbow Foil, we've got Dorinthia's Steel Blade Supremacy. Very strong card. Only Dorinthia can use it. And again, it's a house. And look at that beautiful foiling on that beautiful art. Wow, Dorinthia in all her splendor. All right. The one-a-box, we've got the rainbow foil, Ironrot Helm. If this were an alpha, this would be a cold foil. But in unlimited reprints, these are just rainbow foils. And of course, last but not least, our first box legendary hit, basically a reprint. Think of this as an unlimited power 9. You know, somebody would call this the equivalent of a Moxen. Call this like a Mox Jet or a Mox Ruby, something like that. The Tectonic Plating in rainbow foil. Beautiful card, very useful card. Amazing hit. The box more than paid for itself just with this one card. And yeah, this was a great experience. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. Till next time, bye.